Colnbrook is an extremely confusing village. It stands in three separate counties, Berkshire, Buckinghamshire, and, according to the boundary stone, Middlesex. But the bit that used to be Middlesex is now, in fact, Surrey. Confused? Not half as much as the villagers. Near neighbours find themselves paying very different rate bills for very different services. Pensioners from the Bucks and Barks parts of the village just pop over the boundary to the village post office, which stands in Surrey, for their bus passes. Surrey villagers have to make an 8-mile bus journey to Staines to get theirs. When Buckinghamshire hired a community worker, they had to get an urban aid grant so she could cross the boundaries, much to the amazement of the villagers.
I think they're very confused because they don't realise where I sort of belong to, because I'm employed by Buckinghamshire, especially when I first came. They wondered why I was working in Surrey and in Berkshire as well.
You must have wondered yourself, didn't you, from time to time?
Oh, yes. Very confusing at the beginning.
The village can't have a real planning policy with three county councils, three district councils and a parish council. So it's almost impossible to get anything done.
Very difficult, because nearly everything will mean that we had to approach more than one of the local authorities, and very often all three, which means that we've got to divide our energies amongst them. If they're cooperative, well then perhaps it's not too difficult. If they don't agree with us and we've got a fight, it takes a lot of fighting.
Yeah, what happens when you get different answers from different authorities?
Usually nothing.
There are several residents' associations, and they and the local councillors have sent so many applications to the boundary commissioners that the village's new address is now being made a priority. But first, the villagers will have to overcome their next round of divisions and decide whether they want to be in Surrey, Buckinghamshire or Berkshire. Tricia Ingram's in Colnbrook, somewhere.